Okay, this is my last iteration on the theme on the do-it-yourself digital monitor. It is an Intuos 2. You may recognize its external case that I reused for the whole build. On top, I placed an LG 20 MP48. It is a nice screen, LED backlit, IPS. And it has a resolution of 1440 by 19 pixels, which is not the highest you can find in this day and age. It is 19.5 inches of diagonal, but it was enough for my intended purposes. I wanted to use this as a sketch machine for when I'm home at night. Initially, I thought of just keeping it on my lap, but it is a bit heavy, lighter than my other big screen build, but it's still some 5 kilograms in all, 11.5 pounds if you are imperial inclined. In the end, I had to build a pivoting arm. I already had a lot of the pieces lying around at home. It is a bit on the ugly side of things, but it works relatively well, and I think that I will size it up over the use and maybe rebuild some parts of it in the next few months, when I decide how things go. As you can see, it does its work. It allows to swinging the screen in almost every position that I may want to place it. The only thing, it is maybe a bit too good because it doesn't pose much resistance to the movement, so I need to use one of my legs to keep the monitor in position while I'm drawing. The monitor works really well in the middle where it has nominally no jitter at all. I have some issues on the borders, as always, on the two vertical borders, to be more explicit, and mostly on the right corner of the screen. I suspect that the problem is that I cut the RF cage. The RF cage is down there, and I sized it just on this dimension of the T-Con board of the screen. I suspect that this is a mistake because the electromagnetic field eventually bend on the end around the edges of the RF cage and tangles with the vertical lines that are used by the digitizer to gauge the horizontal position of the pen. Also, I have some false clicks on the side. But using a frequency of 75 Hz, the effect is relatively reduced. As you can see, the jitter in the middle of the screen is nil, virtually nil. 1 pixel, maybe right or left when he remembers to move. If I will ever overhaul it, I'll try build a wider RF cage with the edges that arrive beyond the active area of the digitizer and see if things improves. I suspect, or if you prefer, hope that they will, but I'm not sure because electromagnetic interference is always a bit of an exotic thing. Now I'm going to use it for a bit just to show it. This is my usual numeric pad that I use as hotkeys. This particular pad is nice on one side because it is very thin. It is a bit of an hassle on the other because it tends to double click. It is very sensitive. Some keys are clicks just touching the button without actually pressing it, and it is a bit of an annoyance. If I'll ever find another numeric pad that is a thin and has a better bouncing behavior, I will change it. But for the moment, I keep it. Now, as I said, I built this mostly to do sketches in my free time at home. As such, the fact that it tends to move while I draw is not so much of an issue, but to actually do the final phase of the work, it's better to have a more stable platform. That is the big Ubik 2 that I have in my office. Okay. Now I'm just simply using a big thing. I'm sorry if I lose track of the position of the pen because I am holding the camera with my left hand while I draw with my right hand while keeping the screen from moving away with my legs. So it's a bit of like playing a battery, a drum. As you can see, it works more than decently. If extending the RF cage will solve the jitter problem and more the force clicks on the right side of the screen, it will be virtually perfect. Of course, I also use a bit of a stroke stabilizer called the Nezi Nezumi in my case. This program is Manga Studio. It's an Americanized version of Clip Studio Paint, as far as I know, that also has a stabilization feature included, but I seldom use it because it doesn't extend as much as the functions of Lazy Nezumi, and I already had the Lazy Nezumi license the first time I used the Manga Studio, so I was already used to the external stabilizer. Okay, from now on it will be just me bragging about I'm good at drawing, so I think that it is time to stop. Thank you for your time, and of course, if you have the money, buy the real things. If you don't have the money and have a lot of time, you can buy and build one of these ones. The important thing is paper is dead. See you again, folks.